Hi, my name is Don Michael, and I am currently working on a mask project. I've been asked by the Innovations International Charter School of Nevada to create some masks which will be signed by celebrities and then auctioned off. The proceeds will go towards books and supplies for the school. So I also have the good fortune of having some friends that work in the local news business. They anchor the morning newscast on one of the local affiliates here. And so I asked them if they would autograph a mask, and they said they would love to. Since they're a married couple, I wanted to do a mask that included two faces. So then the challenge is, how do I now take two faces and turn it into a functional mask? What I've done so far is, you can see, I have, using tape, foil, and a mask, starting like this, I have got this prepared to paper mache. I will be paper macheing over the outside of it. It's got the points of the sun. I used a circle behind the mask. I've attached that circle to it to where it'll have a nice transition from the face into the points of the sun. I also have a back piece that these will go together whenever it's all finished. Right now it's doesn't line up. Of course, I've got it all marked where I can line it up perfectly afterwards. This is just foam board that I've cut into shape. I'm actually going to just paper mache right over the top of this for this project too. And then whenever I'm finished, these two will attach. But this isn't the end product. The end product will also include a half mask that will be up against and in a about a two-thirds angle. So it's not going to be straight on, it's not going to be 90 degrees, it's going to be like about a 60 degree angle to the side, and I'm going to turn that into a cloud coming off of the sun. And then whenever I finish, we will see, I anticipate I may even add a small touch of that same cloud coming through the other side, just to kind of give it a nice compositional feel. And all I'm using is just a regular basic old aluminum foil. I pull out a piece big enough to cover the entire thing. I then take the mask and I lay this on top. Now, what I have to do first is I start with the nose, because you really want to just go ahead and get that peaked area first. I gently push it in, and then the most important thing is I want to make sure that it goes into the eyes, but I want to continue to, I want the foil to be represented all the way through the eyes, so as I paper mache, it won't stick to the mask that's underneath. So what I have to do is just kind of push the foil gently down in there without tearing it. And that's really a kind of a nice challenge, because I use the cheaper foil. I don't use the heavy duty, because you want it to conform to the shape really nicely. And the heavy duty foil will fight you all the way through on that. So then once I just gently get the eyes worked in, I continue to just slightly buff it down and work it all the way down to the ends. I go ahead and wrap one end, because it'll start sliding around on you if you don't. And get that worked in, and then just buff it. That's the cool thing about this lesser quality foil, is you can really get those wrinkles just buffed down to where it's almost as smooth as what's below it. And it really conforms to the shape of the mask below it. So I just continually, it's almost like massaging it into the mask, and just continually push. And you can see the face is starting to show up through there, the lips. And the cool thing is, it doesn't matter if the features aren't exact. That's part of what I like about doing these with the paper mache, is it gives such a really neat organic feel. And I think, especially since this is going to be a cloud over the top of the other mask, it'll really add to that feel, having that organic, maybe some crinkly look to it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my palette knife, and then I'm just going to gently poke into there And then I'm going to turn it sideways and do the same thing, basically creating a T inside the eyes. And what I'll do now is just use that to then make sure that the foil stays all the way around the edge. Because once again, I mentioned this earlier, and until you have that problem, you don't realize how drastic it is. You do not want the paper mache to adhere to the mask underneath, because then you got a new dilemma of trying to detach the two from each other. So I want it to be all foil between the mask underneath and the paper mache that I will be putting on top. Now, as I prepared a paper mache, I have prepared some strips already. And what I'm going to use this time is just basically some brown, it's just a package wrapping paper. Just you can bite it in a roll at the store, just like this. And what I've done is I've just used a ruler so I get a nice edge, because it'll go all over the place. Just tear it. You want your strips of paper to always be tore when you're paper macheing, because it gives you a smoother edge or a transition between the pieces. If you've got the hard cut edge, you will see that whenever you have all your seams across there. And you can see all I do, dip it in there, smear it all over, make sure it's really well coated, and then start paper macheing, just putting it on there. What I'll do is I'll start with my eyes a lot of times. You'll notice that there's a blue line right here. This line is where I'm going to actually be cutting it after I'm all finished. The reason I've drawn it on there now is just so I don't waste a lot of paper mache. I'm just going to go over that line and then do this half of the mask. So I just continually just start pushing my paper down in there, getting the glue all over it, and then adhering it to the foil. The nice thing about this foil is after I'm finished, which we'll see later, I can, once it sets enough, I can then just peel the foil off of the mask, the shape that's on the outside that I've put over, or the paper mache over it, will maintain its shape. And then I will just peel the foil before it's completely set off the back of the paper mache. I'm finished with the paper mache now. I've peeled the foil. I've got each of these pieces made, and I'm getting ready to start assembling them. So you may recall also that I had made a blue line across the foil on the mold whenever I'd wrapped the mask in foil. Well, that blue line, what's cool is it actually comes with it. I don't know if you can see it very well on there, but it comes across, the glue ends up picking up that blue, and so now I've got a mark. And so now I'm going to actually stay on that line right there, and I will just, and this is when my butt puckers, I'm starting to cut my work here, you know, I'm like, oh crap, what if I screw it up? But you know what, nothing ventured, nothing gained here. And then we will set that on here. And you can see right away that it's almost there, almost matched perfectly. One of the things I really want to do is kind of try to line the eyes up where it almost feels like the eyes could be together. Holy smokes, I actually hit that pretty close right on. What I've done here is I've got all the pieces assembled now, just to kind of see what it's going to look like with all the pieces laid out. I did a little bit more work on the inside of the what I'll call the male mask. I wanted to go ahead and roll my edges a little bit. I wanted to just fit snug right along the between the nose and the forehead, and everything else to have that cloud look like it's rolling around whenever I get it painted. So I have that now, and I've got it all where it fits nicely, like a nice little puzzle. And I did a little bit of, I actually cut one of the spines, I'm going to show you here, off of the sun here. Reason being, whenever I put it all together and I then glue it together, I got to have space to get my hand down in on the inside here. So what I'm going to do now, the next step, will be painting. I'm starting with just a pure gold here around the face area. I've also mixed it, and you'll see me blending out as I go with some cadmium orange, and then I then added some cadmium red light. So it's a nice, it'll be a blend from a yellow orange all the way out to a red orange Okay, well, I've got my first coat of paint on here. So the sun is about the way I'm going to want it. I'm going to add some more layers of gold like I had spoken of before. And we also have our pieces of the cloud. I'm pretty sure that my cloud is done. I don't even know that I'll put another layer of color on there. There's the big part and then the small one. So you can see here, this will be pretty much what it looks like whenever we're finished, after I do a little bit more touch up on the sun itself, get to that gold. I really want it to glow a little bit more. Okay, well, this journey is just about over, and I thank you guys for coming along with me. Here is the final result as far as putting the mask together. You can see that I've also gessoed the back, camouflaged all my paper mache work. There's only one step left, and that's to go visit with my friends and have them autograph it.